everybody. Josh, the RV nerd of Bish's RV, down here at Forest River Wildwood today, taking a look at their Heritage Glen, or as I like to call it, Harry Glen, 19RBHL. This is the smallest of the entire Heritage Glen and Hemisphere by Salem family. It's a small, lightweight, I think generally speaking, pretty comfortably half-ton towable couples model. So first of all, one of the major critical factors in this one is that it's running on what's called an exact slide system, which is a cable slide mechanism, but it is floor flush, which allows for a true theater seat or hide a bed, or you also have an option for a U-dinette if you like. Major changes up front on this one. First of all, it's got the VersaTilt bed, that power up-down bed incliner, which allows you to kind of sit up in bed and open up the floor space a little bit more to make the whole thing look and feel even bigger. But beyond that, when they went to the VersaTilt bed, they were able to also upfit this with a true queen bed, finally, instead of that short camp queen. So we now have a true queen bed and a full theater seat, which is hard to find in layouts like this. Rockwood builds a similar kind of layout, but until recently, they didn't have a lot of competition giving us a true queen bed and a floor flush slide. So here's another one. Now, they're not the only ones, but they were some of the best ones doing it. The door side of this thing just has, I think, some surprisingly good window coverage with their new square flow windows, which provide good airflow and still have bug screens, but have blackout shades built in to get rid of all the annoying little things. But a major update this season is what's happening with the roof. No more TPO or PVC or anything like that, rubberized roof membrane. It is now a fiberglass roof cap, a lot like you'd find on a motorhome, and that is cool.
And, you know, with 11 other builders making this layout, what makes this one special? That's what I kind of want to focus on the most. Like, there's a lot of things I think you can see, and I might clarify a few things. Like, I like the fact that this is very pet-friendly, you know, very spill-friendly with no vents in the floor or anything like that. The marine woven floor that you're seeing in that floor flush slide over there, which, by the way, floor flush slide's not actually truly floor flush, but they're kind of close. What I'm getting at is the flooring is going to change to match the main flooring, which I think will actually make the whole RV just look better and just look a little bit bigger. Although the window coverage in this is great. You do have the biggest windows on the poop side of the camper, but the camp side of the camper does have some decent window coverage too. It's not terrible. And this is, again, one of the major updates I like right here. This is gone to a 60 by 80 true queen bed. Now, this is that power incliner VersaTilt bed. If you want the head area of the bed to lift up a little bit, you can do that. I'll probably get you a little bit of a look at it later. What I want to demonstrate, though, is what if you don't care about that? What if you just want a queen bed camper? I want you to see that you can do that too with these VersaTilt models. And something, I'm eyeballing it, but I am actually going to see if we can close the slide and leave the bed down. It's going to be super close, but I think it will actually work. Now, I like to share good news, bad news. This RV is a solo or couples camper. Small, compact, but with a big feel because it has an open design bedroom. It does not have any sort of privacy shade. Like, that's just not what this is. It doesn't have a curtain or anything that can pull across. I think Rockwood's pretty good about that. I want to say Cougar, but I could be wrong. There's, again, a lot of builders make stuff like this. Apex Surveyor, they also have their own versions of things like this. Not to mention there's, you know, stick and tin versions out there. So, you know, they all have good qualities, and they all have little things that sort of let you down. It's just a matter of, you know, which things are you looking for? Now, at a glance, the TV is not the best, most perfect view, because if I square the camera up directly across from the sofa, this is kind of what we're looking at here. And the TV's not bad. The good news is the TV can tilt and, or not tilt, it doesn't tilt up and down. It pivots left to right, side to side, and swings out so that you can get a little better, more direct view if you want to. Another thing I think is cool, kind of acting a little bit like dresser space, under the bed right here, you've got those pull-out totes, and you got a little flip-flop and crock shop going on down below it right there. I was wondering if that could be of any use for pets, but I think maybe you could put some pet dishes down there, but it's certainly not big enough for like a cat litter box or anything like that. The kitchen counter space in this one is a little tricky. It's not terrible. They didn't go with a peninsula-style counter the way that, like, Cougar and Surveyor have.
They just kind of ran it all the way to the wall. And then they sort of cut it back slightly right at the end so that getting into and around the bed would be a little bit easier. Otherwise, it would be awful tight right there, especially now that they've gone to that true queen bed. I don't know. What do you think about that? Good decision, bad decision. They did not go with an electric fireplace the way Rockwood has done. However, they are gaining extra drawers in the kitchen as a result. So, like, that's the tricky thing about this is that, you know, everything has ups and downs a little bit. Now, it's 6.5 foot tall inside. It's not extra tall. And not and the big hairy Glens, they actually do maintain a barreled ceiling. The Hyperlite series does not. They're 6.5 foot tall inside. They're not extra tall. That means my head's going to be in the skylight in the shower, but that extra skylight in the kitchen does help. Good news is that these are 50 amp, or, I'm sorry, nope. They're not 50 amp service. It's a 15,000 BTU air conditioner, factory standard on these. Where are the kitchen outlets? They are under the overhead cabinet up there. Not my favorite location for them, but at least they have some, which is better than absolutely none. And remember, you do have a powered USB plug coming off that soundbar right there. They certainly didn't plan and intend on that being used at all related to the kitchen, and I don't know what kitchen things would be USB powered, but nah, you know what, never mind, neither here nor there. The entry door is prepped for a privacy shade. Hyperlites don't include it. The fifth wheels actually do. That's one of the differences when you do step up into a fifth wheel, and we'll get this stuff open, but you got a big 12 volt fridge back there and a large pantry. One of the other things that's nice is we're going to see awesome travel access on this RV. The converter box and everything is nothing is blocked by the slide. Frankly, you can navigate through this entire RV with the slide closed, and it's not an issue whatsoever. Now, because this floor plan doesn't have like a private bedroom, they didn't have a bedroom wall to mount this switch. Your power bed up down switch is actually located over here, which is a somewhat, it feels like a weird location for it, but at the same time, does it matter? Does it matter where it's located? And in a way, it's someone might say, well, why didn't they just mount it right in the bed? Well, the thing is, the power incliner that they're using on this, it's not rated to have somebody actually occupying the bed while it goes up and down. It's not like a residential orthopedic system. It's a light duty, you know, actuator arm, effectively. And there's just little things like that of which you need to be careful. Now, inside that armrest, there are some USB plugs. I'll get you a little bit better look at that. And actually, you know what? As long as we're looking at the sofa over here, let's go ahead and just crack this open. Let's show you, like, you got the blackout integrated day-night shades in those square flow windows. And again, you have multiple seating swaptions available on this. Like, we're looking at the wall-hugging theater seat today, but you might notice how there's a little bit of a gap on each side of that sofa. That's because this is actually sized for a true U-dinette if you do want a big 7-foot U-dinette in here. Or you could, I think they offer a hide-a-bed as well. And both the sofas will include that bracket-attached table that basically we're looking at right there, which it's not the kind of table where you want to, like, push down on it while you're standing up. It's just, it's there for light duty, like if you just want to put a dinner plate on it or a keyboard, a wireless keyboard, and like you have your laptop plugged into the TV or something like that. Like, I could see this kind of working for something like that, for some, you know, smart TV kind of purposes or anything of that regard. But that's what this one is. But it is nice that they give you a lot of different seating swaptions. Surveyors also very, very good for that. But I don't think they really do true U-dinettes. They only do a 60-inch wide two-bench dinette. Some folks have a preference for one. Some folks have a preference for other. Now, this is kind of a key critical detail. You see these cutaway side pockets? I'm going to get you another look, better look inside there. But they also have household and USB outlets just in that little carved cutaway. So that if you, you know, you want to have a phone charger or something in there, you got a great little spot to do it. Storage. Let's start looking around all the storage stuff. I'm trying to figure which way I want to go about it. Sorry. I don't pre-script anything, so sometimes I have these weird dead air periods. Let's crack that sucker open right there, give you a little bit of a look around. I like that they've revised this a little bit, where you do have drawers on both sides of the bed, not to mention you got all those you know, storage totes down under the bed. By the way, if you want to lift the bed to access that storage, you must have the bed in the down position. And that tabletop that we saw a second ago,
That is intended to be stored under the mattress in transit. There's actually some buckle straps located under there so that if you, sorry, my brain again just went on pause. But if you're going to go down the road, you don't want that table floating around smashing and everything. That's where you store it, is actually stuff it under the mattress. And there you go. Although, I am still thinking that we can probably leave the mattress down on this floor plan all the time. You can't do that in every Harry Glen, but I think in this one you can. And the kitchen's not bad. Even though it's not an extra tall interior camper, they're very good about throwing shelving in that overhead cabinet space above the sink to really maximize all the storage in here. And under the sink, I is almost feels maybe too open. And I don't know why my voice goes up when I say like two octaves like that, but hey, there we are. I like the fact that I could put a big wastebasket down there under that sink. But other than that, what are you going to do with that space? What would you do with the big wide open space that you saw under that big farm sink right there? Because for me, I almost feel like I want one side to have shelving and the other side to not have shelving. I don't know. Maybe it makes sense to me. Now, they did something here that a lot of manufacturers have not. They went with a sliding door and a rectangular shower, not a radius shower. And that offers a lot more elbow room. Now, you're going to have to depend on the skylight for headroom if you are a little over 6 foot tall like I am. You know, if you're a little bit more, say, gravity friendly, well, you're probably not going to have to worry about it. I'm guessing if you're like 5'8", 5'9", you'll probably fit in here just perfectly fine. Perfect little spot for the butt napkin roller over there right next to the toilet. It seems like the one makes sense next to the other. It's a little tight in that bathroom. Don't get me wrong. It's not the worst I've ever seen, though. And you do have yourself a couple, you know, like rhino, elephant beetle looking things sticking out of the wall here to be able to hang up some towels, hand towels, whatever, to keep those things dried off. And that's all cool. But one of the great things about this floor plan is the road mode travel access is fantastic. And I was right. I eyeballed it correctly. They went to the true queen bed. They didn't extend the camper, but it does just clear the slide out. So if you don't care about the versatile bed, if you just want to leave the bed down, if you want to get a nice heavy duty aftermarket true queen mattress, you can absolutely do that in here, and this RV is still a viable option for you. Because that's the thing, with that Versatilt, I think it's kind of tuned for the lightweight backbreaker death wafer mattresses that you get from factories. I have a suspicion if you went to like a real heavy-duty, thick pillow top, it probably wouldn't work. So at least this is something you don't have to make the choice of sleeping well or not. Like, you have the opportunity to sort of choose how you want to go about it. So bathroom, kitchen, the bed. This is a very travel functional model that just works better for folks that are a little bit bigger like me than it ever used to. And this is something that, generally speaking, I think a lot of half tons are going to handle pretty comfortably and pretty readily. Under 24 foot tip to tail, including that whole tongue and coupler and everything, and a maximum fully loaded with cargo weight of 7,530 pounds. That is something that a half ton should move around pretty well, especially considering the wide stance stability axle package you have with those Goodyear Endurance radials down there. Basically, it helps the RV feel like it's a little bit shorter when you're towing it. Now, obviously, your actual length doesn't change, but it tends to make the RV wiggle and sway less. And I tell you what, RV delivery drivers I've talked to over the years, they sure swear by those things. They think that works pretty darn well. You have a monstrously large front compartment up there. It kind of reminds me, like, North Trail calls it their King Kong size storage. Well, Harry Glen doesn't have a special word for it, but it's that. It's big. It's real big. The awning feels like maybe they could have tried to squeeze a little extra space out of it, but awnings are funny. You can't order awnings by the inch. The awning builders build them in specific sizes, so they weren't able to extend backwards because it would conflict with that 60,000 BTU tankless on-demand water heater, and they may not have been able to extend it forward so it didn't conflict with that gigantic oversized baggage compartment right there. So it could be a case where the cool things they did got in the way of other potentially cool things. But up top, you can see wrapping over the sidewall, the roof line, you have that new fiberglass roof cap on these, and I think that's a major deal. They're one of the very first mainstream travel trailer builders I've ever seen do something like that. And they're not the first ones to necessarily just have fiberglass on the roof, but the kind of volume that a brand like this carries and represents, they're the first big volume major player I've seen do something like that. I think it's potentially signaling a bit of a change in the wind, because from my experience has been when one manufacturer does something cool, if people like it, other manufacturers tend to do it very, very quickly. Some of the things I like about it: better protection, reduced maintenance, not zero maintenance, reduced maintenance. If you notice how that roof cap actually wrapped over the sidewall, you move an area of high stress where the roof and the wall meet, and you move it to an area of low stress on the sidewall. So that seam is getting far less stress as a result. Now, one of the things, there's so many good qualities in this one. Something that really kind of baffles me on this, I can only estimate that their wide stance stability suspension was part of this here. It's a two-headed sewer monster of a tiny camper. We've got bathroom black and gray back here, but you also have a kitchen gray up here just in front of the slide. And its location under the slide is actually kind of rough. And, you know, I hope you appreciate that. I could have easily pretended I didn't see that and not gotten up close on the driver's side of the RV up here. But, man, if I was going to go spending a lot of money, those are the things I would really want to know. Like the potential major annoying inconvenience factors that may cause me to grow to hate an RV. And maybe that thing is fine for you. This is certainly a popular model, and overall, I think it does more good than bad. But that could be a major issue for someone, and I think that's the kind of thing that you deserve to know, you know? Something else you deserve to know: the underbelly of this. It is enclosed, it is forced air heated, they do have tank heaters, and they do have a radiant barrier package. Now, what I respect is that they don't call this some magic any weather package, but it is a very respectable extended season setup. Now, a really cool thing with a floor plan like this is that it's a really good layout, so a lot of builders make it. So you have a lot of the ability to be very choosy and specific about the things you want. And that's why I'm gonna leave you some links in the description to check out a bunch of other videos to some builders who have made a layout like this, as well as check for pricing and availability here on our Hemi-Glen Harrispheres, whatever you wanna call them. So when you're ready, we're ready. And remember, we don't do hidden dealer fees, we just do everything else for you. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.